Hello everyone, myself Sampreet Patel, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. After looking at how to create an HTML page, we'll go forward to how we can style and format an HTML page. So after this video, you'll be able to recognize styling and formatting tags in HTML, and you will be able to apply the same to a basic web page using HTML. So what is styling? When you have to display anything on a website or a web page, you need some styling to be done to make a website attractive. So setting the style in an HTML element can be done using the style attribute. So the basic syntax is the tag name which you are going to use. You have to use a style attribute and you have to give its property and value. So properties of the style attribute, there are many properties that can be applied to any tag in an HTML page. So we'll see this. Now you know these basic tags that we have seen in last video, that is the HTML tag, the title tag, the head tag, and the body tag. So anything that can be written or to be displayed on the web page is to be written in the body tag. Okay, so moving forward to styling. So now we want to give a background color. So we'll start with the background color. So we want to give a background color to our web page. So what we'll do is we'll just say style, call the style attribute equal to double quote. The attribute property name will be background color colon whatever color you want. The color you can give it in directly the color name. For example, say we'll give blue and we'll end it with semicolon so that you can give multiple properties to your styles. So I'll save this. See, the background color it changed to blue. Now this property value can be given in three ways. Either you can give directly the name of the color, or you can give hashtag of that color. So hash, let's say 0E0E0E. I have no idea what this code color is. So see, this is a type of dark gray color that we have given. And the another is you can give in the form of RGB value. That is, just we'll give black 255, 255 and 255. That are the parameters for the ratio of red, green and blue. So see, this is the white. If you do it 0, 0, 0, I'll save it and I'll refresh it. It will give you black color. Okay. So this was about background color to a web page. After that, if you want to, I'll just remove this style tag so the background color remains white and we can see other styling options. Now you have to change the color of this particular line, which is styling an HTML page. I'll just refresh. You can see this styling an HTML page. So to this tag, you can again call the style attribute equal to double quote and you'll say just color. And the color will be, we'll say, I'll give red. Okay. And I'll refresh it. So the color it changed to red. Accordingly, I've told you that the HTML have predefined font sizes for H1 to H6 and the P tag, which is used to write the paragraph on a HTML page or a web page. So you can also change the size of this particular line. So we'll say font size colon. Now this can be given in two ways. Either you can define a pixel, say we'll give 70px, that stands for 70 pixels. We'll save this. Okay. So it has increased by 70 pixel. The another way is you can give percentage. So percentage is with respect to the basic font style they have provided. Okay, so it is 70%. So in this way you can change the font size of the predefined tags in the HTML. After that we have another tag, say alignment of the font or alignment of your content on an HTML page. So we have text align. So this may have three parameters. Either you can give it left, which is by default, or right. We will save it. So the text is moved to the right alignment. And center. Okay, so the text is displayed in the center of your web page. So this is how you can align your HTML content using text align. It has three parameters: left, right, and center. Accordingly, it will display your text on the subsequent size. So moving forward, if you want to make the particular, say, HTML bold, so you don't have to define it in the styling options. You can directly define it like B. You'll open the B tag, you have that tag, and you will close it. So now see what happens is, okay, we are using the header tag, so it is already bold. So I'll just change this tag to a paragraph tag. Okay. Now see, only HTML is bold and all other font style is normal, that is not bold. Okay. Similarly, I'll just increase the font size to so that we will be able to read it properly. So we'll say, I'll do it same 70px, that is pixels. Okay, see, now HTML is bold. I'll just show you again. I'll remove this B tag and you'll see the difference. Okay, so HTML has again become in the normal font. Similarly, if you want to make it italic, we can use I. You have to close all the tags properly. See, in this way. So another tag, that is, if you want to show the importance of that particular thing, you can use the tag strong. So it will also change your font to bold. So we'll just see what is the difference between B tag and the strong tag. So I'll just copy and paste it. So I'll call a B tag here. Okay, I'll give a page break. So using BR, we can give a break of line. So there is no difference between using a B tag and a strong tag. So now you can also define your font family. So what type of font you want. So basically, before defining this particular thing, we need to install the font required. So we'll say we'll use Courier. So in that way you can change the font of your content. So other thing, if you want to write a subscript or a superscript for your particular content, so I'll take another tag. And we'll see I'll just put, I want to write 2, 4 raised to 2. So it should all look like the 2 should be above 4. So what I'll do is, I'll just say sup, that is a superscript. I'll say 2, I'll end the superscript. Okay. I'll just put this particular styling to the next paragraph tag as well. We don't require the font family, just the font color alignment and font size. Okay. So see, 4 raised to 2. So using the superscript tag, that is SUP, you can use this particular, if you want to display any formulas on your website or a web page, you can use this. Also, if you want subscript, you can use SUB. So as 2 was displayed above 4, it will now be displayed below 4 as a subscript. Okay. So moving forward, I'll just give you a task. Design a proper resume using an HTML. So take a time. So I'll just show you, I have done this. So see, this is the particular page I have created. For the background color, I have used background color. I'll just show you the code. You can check it out. So see, I have used padding, I have used text alignment. There are a number of properties that can be applied to a style attribute. You can go through it online. You will find different attributes according to your needs. Okay. So this is how a web page has been created for a resume. Okay. So these are some references that I have used, and you can go through it for different properties for your styling. Thank you.